Ho Biscuits, it's your girl Skitten. I am here rocking my t-shirt from Tino Evil. And I got hella compliments on my shirt today, even though I only left the house one time. So, I'm here today to watch 25 terrifying sea creatures that actually exist. Now, I don't know how many of you guys have been to the Discord or know really anything about me, but I am terrified of whales, actually. Like, I was gonna say of the ocean, but mostly whales, okay? Whales, sharks, a little bit kind of dolphins, you know, sea lions. Animals that are bigger than me and could eat me, whether on purpose or by accident, I am afraid of. So this video is kind of like watching a horror movie for me, and it's about as close as me watching a horror movie as you guys are ever gonna get. So, enjoy.
Factsverse presents 25 terrifying sea creatures.
Terrifying.
Number 1, the goblin shark. Since only a few of these deep sea sharks have been caught by fishing boats, not much is known about them. It has a prominent snout and a retractable jaw. Its razor sharp teeth are enough to send even the strongest person swimming for land. Number 2, the dragonfish. Although the dragonfish is found over a mile below sea level, it starts its life on top of the water as an egg. As it gets older, it descends to the depths of the sea. As an adult, it's able to produce its own light, which is known as bioluminescence.
I know what bioluminescence.
One of its lights is found on a barbell attached to its jaw.
Why does it look like that?
Its razor-sharp teeth make it a very frightening creature. Number 3, the frilled shark. This is a shark that is rarely seen.
It looks like a boomerang.
Pacific Oceans. Scientists believe.
Okay, that's a little less funny.
Prey. It bends its body like a snake. When it's close enough, it swallows its victim whole. Thankfully, humans are not close enough in the water to become its prey. Number 4, the vampire squid.
That's not terrifying. It's cute.
This sea creature.
Okay,
has
that's
the
a little weird
eyes
looking.
Of any animal in the world, proportionally speaking. This creature lives in the depths of the deep
that's
sea.
A little weird.
Many people
that
think
so
that
cute.
It gets its name because it sucks blood with its tentacles, but this is false. The tentacles are actually rather weak. It actually gets its name from its red eyes and its cloak-like webbing. It is a very scary-looking creature. Number 5, the big red jellyfish.
they ran out of names. They just called it the big red jellyfish.
In length. And it's slightly red, which is where the name came from.
Yeah, we got
Rather
it.
Rather than using tentacles like most jellyfish have, this type uses fleshy feeding arms to capture its prey. Number 6, the giant squid. The giant squid was just a legend for a long time because it was rarely ever seen by humans. It lives deep below the waves, and its only predator is the sperm whale. The two are famous for their deadly fights beneath the sea,
creepy.
And their carcasses can often be found bearing the marks of the battle. This is a creature that you would not want to run into underwater.
Creepy.
Number 7, the blobfish.
It's like a fat Severus Snape.
It's like a fat Severus Snape.
Australia and New Zealand, and lives almost 4,000 feet below sea level. Because the pressure at these depths
is much
like higher than near the surface, the blob's fish body is a gelatinous mass. Since humans
he looks so
get
unhappy.
That far under the sea, you won't need to worry about running into this one. Number 8, the coffin fish. This fish looks like a pink, spine-covered balloon.
Yeah.
Its appearance makes it seem to be the cross between a puffer fish and an
angler. Not terrifying
fish.
At all.
They hunt deep below the sea.
He has a little
thing on
his
nose.
And
they catch their prey using a fleshy protrusion the same way that an angler fish does. When they feel threatened, they are capable of puffing themselves up to scare away their enemies.
Okay.
The same way that a puffer fish can.
So, like, it is.
Number
9,
the giant isopod. This creature is permanently stuck to the bottom of the ocean. At no time are they able to swim to the surface. It lives in the cold, dark waters of the Atlantic Ocean and the Arctic
Circle. It's like a giant roach.
It resembles a crab.
Oh, it's like a giant roach.
But it's much larger in
size. Oh, it's like a giant roach.
Since it doesn't float to the surface, you won't need to worry about running into one if you're swimming in the ocean.
Oh, it's like a giant roach.
Number 10, Stargazer. This is a very creepy looking creature. It gets its name because its eyes and mouth are located on top of its head.
It looks like a rock.
It buries itself in the sand, and it pops up to attack its prey when it swims by. Some species of the stargazer are electric, and they can deliver lethal shocks to their prey and predators. Number 11.
Chimera. Oh, it's cute!
This creature should not be confused with the chimera of Greek mythology.
It's so cute!
And they're also known as sharks.
That's
While these
not
creatures
terrifying.
Used to be found all over the ocean, today they are mostly confined to deep water. They have the body of a shark and the mouth of a crocodile. Luckily, they no longer come to the surface.
That's not luckily, that's
Number
because
12,
of us.
The amphipod. These tiny crustaceans are no longer than an inch, and they live deep in the Pacific Ocean and close to 4 miles beneath the waves. There are some amphipods, however, that can grow a foot in length. They're a very creepy creature and are the cross between a lobster and a cockroach. Number 13. The Pacific Black Dragon. This creature got its name for a reason. Since most of its prey is bioluminescent, its stomach is designed to prevent light from radiating through. It can easily sneak up on its prey without them even knowing.
That's fucked up.
It actually looks like a black garden snake.
I was gonna say that's
If you hate
a snake.
Snakes, you'll want to steer clear of this creature.
I like snakes, but I don't
Number
want that
14,
thing.
The Dumbo Octopus.
Wait, okay.
This octopus got his name from the elephant in the Disney movie, Dumbo. It's not quite as terrifying as the frilled shark,
homie.
However, it is so strange-looking, it deserves a spot
no,
on our
doesn't.
List.
No, it doesn't. It's cute.
Number 15. The anglerfish.
Anglerfish are horrifying. Finding Nemo taught me that.
Like something out of a science fiction movie. This fish got its name for the way that it hunts. It uses a fleshy protrusion that comes out the top of its
head. Okay, that is just an artistic rendering. They don't
Once
actually
close
look
enough,
like that.
It will use its razor-sharp teeth to eat the unlucky creature. Number 16. The gulper eel.
The fuck
eel.
Is that?
This eel is also
Why
known
do all of
as
these
the pelican
creatures
eel.
Look
it
like
is one
this.
Of the strangest and scariest
Jesus
looking creatures
Christ.
In the deep sea. Its mouth is huge, making it possible for it to swallow prey that is much larger than itself. Its razor-sharp teeth also
and
allow it to
teeth?
Chew its food if necessary. Number 17. The snaggletooth.
Oh, now that's fucked up, talking about
this
its fucking appearance.
This is by far one
Come
of
on.
The ugliest creatures on
that's
our
rude.
List.
That's rude.
Its razor-sharp teeth are jagged and uneven, making it look very threatening. It can produce its own light, which makes it very easy to hunt its prey. Number 18. The hatchetfish. This fish should not be confused with the hatchetfish that can be found in many aquariums and are freshwater fish. This
it looks like a zombie fish.
Was named for
like
its distinctive
it's already dead.
Hatchet-shaped body. Its eyes are located on top of its head, which allows it to catch food that falls
That's
from
weird.
Above. It is only found in the great depths of
That's
the ocean.
Weird looking.
Therefore, you won't need to worry about running into one of these frightening creatures.
Appreciate it.
Number 19, the barrel eye. These odd-looking creatures are similar to the hatchet fish,
what the fuck?
As they have eyes on top of their heads to catch their prey.
What the fuck?
What makes them so unique is the transparent dome on top of their head that encases and protects their eyes. Number 20, the grenadier. This is a bottom-dwelling fish, and they are very abundant, as they make up about 15% of the deep-sea population. They are found at depths of almost 4 miles. There are very few creatures that can survive in such a deep, hostile environment. Its razor-sharp teeth make it a force to be reckoned with. Number 21.
The blue-ringed octopus. I love those. I think they're so cute.
At first glance, this octopus doesn't look scary. It's actually quite pretty, in fact. However, looks can be deceiving. It's actually one of the most dangerous creatures in the ocean. Its venom is extremely potent. Since there is no anti-venom, you want to steer clear of this creature.
You did.
Number 22. The megamouth shark. This species of deep water shark
oh
was
God.
Discovered in 1976 and has rarely ever
oh
been seen
God.
By
Oh my God, please
humans.
Tell me that
because
this, oh my God.
Seen, there is really no scientific facts about this creature. Its distinctive feature is its gaping mouth, which can swallow its prey whole.
No.
Number 23. The viper fish.
That shit was terrifying.
During the day, this fish stays in the deep water. At night, it travels to the surface and has been found in the nets of deep-sea fishermen. Since they cannot survive in captivity, not much is known about them except that they are very scary-looking. Just their razor-sharp teeth are enough to make anyone run away screaming. Number 24. The Black Swallower. This fish is also known as the Great Swallower.
Ew.
What makes this creature so scary is its ability to consume and digest. This relatively small creature can eat and digest prey that is over 10 times its size. Number 25. Gigantic Sunfish.
What the fuck is that?
A group of scuba divers was in the water taking photos when they happened upon this gigantic sunfish. The fish can grow up to 9 feet long and can weigh over 5,000 pounds. The sunfish that the divers came across was large enough to easily inhale a grown man. Luckily for the men, this type of fish does not eat humans. Just the sheer size of this fish alone is enough to make a person swim in the other direction if they were to happen upon it.
Holy shit.
Subscribe for more.
Like, these little homies, I'm not worried about them. They can live their life. That's cool. But like, that megamouth shark, what do you do? It just opens its mouth and you're dead. You're dead. You're eaten. That's it. I understand that the sunfish dude doesn't eat people, but like, I would pass out. I would pass the fuck out. What is not on this list that would also terrify me is gigantic manta rays. Yeah, I would cry. The ocean terror is terrifying, guys. The ocean is actually a horrifying, horrifying, horrifying place. Which is why global warming is bad. Because if California falls into the ocean, Las Vegas will be just that much closer to the ocean. And it'll be horrible. I mean, like, that's not the only reason that, like, global warming, whatever. Y'all know what I mean. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to leave your comments and suggestions below. You'll be able to find the link to the original video below. Also, I'm going to be making a get to know Skitten get ready with me where I do my makeup and talk to you guys and answer your questions. So don't forget to leave your questions below, okay? Okay. Thanks, guys.